Welcome to Dan's On Fandoms. I'm Dan. Greg Pak's Darth Vader comic series recently released issue 11, which featured some very interesting bits of info and Easter eggs, including this mamma jamma. So what the hell is going on Exegol? What's Sidious up to? And is this severed hand Luke's? To quickly recap, after securing the Sith Wayfinder from the Eye of Webbish Bog earlier in the series, Darth Vader and Ochi of Bestoon traveled to Exegol, the ancient planet of the Sith, and, en route, came across a gigantic space creature, tamed and controlled it, and rode that bitch right on into Exegol. Vader then planned to attack his master, Darth Sidious, with his force-controlled behemoth, but Sidious also apparently had his own beasts he controlled with the Force, ready and waiting to take on his apprentice. After Vader's behemoth killed Sidious's giant crustaceans, Sidious used the Force to crush Vader's beast as if he was crushing a grape. Sidious then descended into the depths of the Sith Citadel, prompting Vader to submit to and follow after his master. Now, this is where things get just even more wild. As Vader and Ochi of Bestoon follow Sidious and make their way through the bowels of the Sith Citadel, they come upon the clone tanks that we saw in the Rise of Skywalker, which the film showed were used to create clones of Snoke. While the clones in this issue are not Snoke, they do bear a resemblance to him, so we can surmise that it took Sidious and his Sith cultists time to perfect the cloning process to be able to create Snoke. This notion was echoed in the Rise of Skywalker novelization, which mentioned that it took time for the Sith cultists to be able to clone a body that was suitable to house Sidious's essence following his death on the second Death Star. So, it would make sense that it took time for Snoke to be created, making me wonder if it was indeed a Snoke clone we saw in Season 2 of The Mandalorian. Anyway, as Vader continues on, he happens upon a jar with a severed hand which, I immediately thought that the hand has to be Luke's. In Legends, after his duel with Luke, Darth Vader found and acquired Luke's severed hand and lightsaber from an Ugnaught on Cloud City, gave the hand and saber to Palpatine, and then years later was used by Joris Sabaoth to create a dark side clone of Luke. After Vader sees the severed hand, nothing else is stated or mentioned about it in the comic. With that said, did Sidious and his cultists use Luke's severed hand when creating Snoke? As Vader sees the severed hand, Sidious is talking about pain, or the scalpel of creation as he calls it, and tells Vader that he used pain to make everything Vader sees in the Sith Citadel, and that he can use it to make anything. Although it's not outright stated that Sidious used Luke's hand to create Snoke, I think the implication is there, and we can at least say that there's a very strong possibility it was used in Snoke's creation. I have to say, I think it'd be pretty sweet if Luke's hand was used to create Snoke. I'm not a fan of the Legends Darkseid clone of Luke, so I think it'd be much cooler if we eventually learn that Snoke was created from Luke's DNA. Sidious then unleashed these weird clones on Vader, which he quickly killed, and then Sidious had a horde of Sith cultists attack Vader, which Vader also dispatched of. From there, Vader then witnesses the forge that is creating the planet-killing Star Destroyers from the Rise of Skywalker, which confirms that Sidious had been building that fleet of Star Destroyers sometime after The Empire Strikes Back and before Return of the Jedi, but he may have even began building that fleet even earlier than that. The Sith Lord then revealed to Vader that he harvested a mountain of Kyber Crystal to power his planet-killing Star Destroyer fleet, which we see is being mined and possibly tormented by minions of Sidious. To serve the Sith, Vader explained to Ochi that the Kyber, which is a living mineral, must suffer. Essentially, Sidious and his minions were bleeding the gigantic swath of Kyber, causing it to emit a tremendous amount of power, which scorched Ochi's eyes. Vader soon agreed to share in the Sith Lord's power and fully submitted to his master, but not before we see him thinking of Luke after their duel, but instead of Vader telling Luke that Sidious foresaw the boy destroying the Emperor, we see it's Luke telling Vader this. Greg Pak, you genius son of a bitch, I love this comic. The issue ends with Vader, Mos Amita, Sly Moore, and a bandaged Ochi of Bestoon following Darth Sidious. Greg Pak continues to release Slam Dunk after Slam Dunk with this Darth Vader series, and Darth Vader number 11 is no exception. I've seen a lot of people stating this issue confirms Luke's hand was used in Snoke's creation, and while I do think that could definitely be the case, at no point in the issue is it stated that Luke's hand was used to create Snoke. It would make sense that Force-sensitive DNA would be used in Snoke's creation, and using Luke's severed hand would be a cool tie-in to what happened to his hand in Legends. Nevertheless, I think it's pretty damn sweet tweet that Pox Darth Vader is showing Sidious's machinations during the time between Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi that will eventually culminate during the sequel trilogy and the Rise of Skywalker. Pretty frickin' awesome. Let's hope Darth Vader number 12 is just as fun. But what do you guys think? Do you think Luke's hand was used to create Snoke? Let us know down in the comments. If you like this video, please help out the channel by hitting that like button and making sure you subscribe. Follow the channel on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, all at Dan's on Fandoms. Thanks for watching, and stay nerdy.